you got to be glad you got out there and played.
Yeah, that was the first victory of the day, was be able to beat the weatherman. And, you know, last night I was devastated. I let the dogs out to go to the bathroom before I was getting ready to go to bed, and the dog comes in with snow all over, and I looked, and it was snowing. And everyone in Knoxville missed that one. But it didn't damper our spirit. I knew that our grounds people, and I want to commend our grounds guys, for the last 3 days have done an unbelievable job to allow us this opportunity to play today. And I'm glad our team took advantage of that and played good baseball. The first game, it was a well-pitched game, and we scrapped out enough runs off their starting pitcher that I thought was tough to win 3-0. And then in the second game became an offensive onslaught by our guys. What I saw in the fall, I saw that our guys can score a lot of runs, and we were a little sloppy with some fly balls. When we started getting top half of the baseball, we started to put some big innings together. And but this game could be looked upon as an offense a day, and it was to some extent, especially in the second game. But I want to commend our relief pitchers, Nick Williams, Drake Owenby, Andy Cox, and Trevor Betancourt. Did fabulous jobs coming in. And I've said from the get-go, I thought we were going to be strong in the bullpen, and we still didn't use some guys that we have for tomorrow. And I thought our bullpen, our relief guys did an excellent job.
How encouraging is it to see, you know, both of the wins kind of come in two different ways? I mean, obviously Kyle pitched pretty well. He only gave up 2 runs, but obviously the offense is what dominated the second game. How encouraging is it to see?
Very encouraging. I think we're going to be an offensive. We're a tough offense. I had to deal with it all fall and in the winter before we started. And we're going to make some teams pay. Good pitching always shuts down good hitting a lot. But we're going to make some teams pay if they can't keep running arms out there at us. And I think we showed a little bit of signs of that today. I'm just proud of the guys. It was a long day, first day, long day, and they stayed involved for 18 innings and a lot of positive energy coming out of that dugout. And I think this team realizes what I've been saying for a long time. We have a chance to be good, but we still got to prove it each and every day on the field. And I think maybe the biggest game of the year might be tomorrow. You know, when you win a game lopsided like we did tonight, tomorrow's a mentality day. It's a disciplined day, and the game's not going to be easy. Obviously, Purdue has some pride, and they're going to come out to try to sniper us in the third game of the series.
The way that, I guess, you know, that second game went, I mean, was the pitching that much different in the first game or the second game, or do you think maybe the guys, after having a game to get settled in, were a little
Well, yeah, you know, no matter how much we talk about it and try to coach it, it's hard, you know, everyone's a little nervous. The unknown, first game and first at bat and getting that first hit. And I think the guys just settled in and you know, hitting's contagious, and we kind of proved that. I mean, there were some innings that we strung some good at-bats together, and I really felt that the tide turned when we started getting top half of the baseball, when we started beating some of their infielders with some hard Division I ground balls. I thought in the first game, a little bit of a loopy swings, a lot of fly balls, too many strikeouts, and the start of the second game kind of started out like that, and then we started getting the top half of the baseball, and I thought it really turned the game for us.
I'm sure, like Kyle said, you know, you would have liked to have seen him be a little, I guess, smoother with the first start there, but to kind of grit out 5 innings there and have to do a little bit of damage control and work out some things, I guess maybe better now than later in terms of working out some things.
Yeah, the expectations are pretty high for him, and that's what, and for me too, and for every one of our players, and I think he's got to get off that expectation and just be a freshman that's going to grow up in a tough SEC. He did handle things well. His command wasn't what I liked it to be, nor I think he thinks it should be. But he handled the situation well, and he's got a lot of fight in him, and he wants to be the best. I want every one of our players to be the best. So he's going to be critical of his performance, and we'll go back to the drawing board and work on some things. But it, just like it was for Hunter Martin, it's start one of your collegiate career, and you know, those guys gave us 8 innings combined to give this team a chance to win.
Anything else? All right.